He was a doer. He was a guy doing things, not only speaking. Gago has made so many actions that it's very difficult to put in just a few words his legacy. But if I have just one example, and this is related to space and the European Space Agency, because this is what I know the most, he has made a fantastic thing. When Portugal joined ESA, there was almost no industry in Portugal. No enterprise, and what he has done, and it was in agreement with me, he has paid for students to come at ESA for 2 years. This is what we were calling the young graduate trainees. And these guys, they were spending 2 years, some of them 3 years in ESA, to train, to understand, to learn, to complete their education. And after that, they came back to Portugal. And they have created all the startup, all the young enterprise, which have developed the necessary expertise in Portugal for making Portugal a happy member state. And each time I was coming here, in this very place, when there was exhibition every year with the enterprise and so on, it was always the young people that I have met when they were at ESA, who were the ones to present what they were doing in Portugal. And that is a fantastic achievement from Monsieur Gago. There are many challenges. The world will be very different because population is growing. We shall be 11 billion of inhabitants on planet Earth in 2100. The resources are decreasing because we are using more and more resources of planet Earth, and a significant part of the resources are not renewable. The climate change will have dramatic consequences. Even if we limit to 2 degrees the elevation of temperature globally, we know already that there will be a lot of consequences on the and certainly a change in the repartition of the population. So the world will be so different that we need different solutions. We cannot just take the solutions of the past or even the solutions of today. We have to invent the solutions to make life possible on planet Earth. And for that, we have to make so many progress in so many different fields, in terms of agriculture, in terms of energy, in terms of utilization of resources, and so on, that we need more and more experts, we need more and more scientists, we need more and more engineers, and this is the reason why we have to invest in science and technology.